In this segment, we'll look at an example of see if certain vectors which are given to you are they linearly independent. So the question is that the problem statement which is being asked as an example is that R A1, which is given as this vector 1, 2, 5, A2 vector is given as 2, 5, and 7, and then A3 vector is given as 6, 14, and 24. And you asked, are these three vectors linearly independent? So we can very well see that if I was going to develop a linear combination of these three vectors, k1 times a1 plus k2 times a2 plus k3 times a3, where k1, k2, and k3 are scalars, and put them equal to the 0 vector, then we can very well see that k1 equal to 0, k2 equal to 0, k3 equal to 0 is a possible solution. And that's the trivial solution for this particular problem. So in order to be able to justify whether it's linearly independent or not, we got to see if there's some other solution other than the non-trivial solution. Now, one of the things which you can see just by observation is that it looks like that A3 is 2 times A1 plus 2 times A2. And why is that so? It's because if you multiply the first element, the first component here by 2, that gives you 2. Then you multiply this by 2, gives you 4, and 2 plus 4 is 6. Same here, 2 times 2 is 4, 5 times 2 is 10, 10 plus 4 is 14. 2 times 5 is 10, and 2 times 7 is 14, and that gives you 24, 10 plus 14, 24. So it seems that this A3 vector is 2 times A1 plus 2 times A2. What that simply means is that A3 minus 2A1 minus 2a2 is equal to the 0 vector. So what that means is that there is a combination of other than 0, 0, 0. So let me put 1 here. So what you're finding out, there is a combination of these scalars being other than 0, which also gives us a 0 vector. So in a way, we're saying, hey, k1 is minus 2, k2 is minus 2, and k3 is equal to 1 is a solution. And what we are finding out is that we're getting a solution which is not the trivial one, but we're getting another solution which is non-trivial. And hence that means that these three vectors are not linearly independent. So A1, A2, and A3 are not linearly independent. Or what we can also call is A1, A2, and A3 are linearly dependent. And that's how we're able to do this. But the question arises that, hey, this I was able to believe because of some observation which I had that, hey, the A3 vector is 2 times A1 plus 2 times A2. How can we do that if we are not able to observe it? And that's what, let's go and see how that is done. Let's write down the combinations for the three vectors. We have k1 and we have the first vector is 1, 2, 5. So we're writing the linear combinations of the three vectors which are given to us. 2, 5, and 7 plus k3, 6, 14, and 24 equal to 0, or the 0 vector. So what that means is that if I'm going to bring all of these together, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring all of the left-hand side together, and the right-hand side will be the 0 vector because I'll get 3 components there. So I'll get k1 plus 2k2 plus 6k3 from the first one. And similarly, the second one will be 2k1 plus 5k2 plus 14k3. Then we'll have 5k1 plus 7k2 plus 24k3 right here. So that's what I get as the three equations, three unknowns. So you got to see that this is the first equation will be k1 plus 2k2 plus 6k3 equal to 0. And similarly, the second and the third equation. And what I'm going to do is I'm only going to look at the first two equations and see what the relationship between k1, k2, and k3 is. And so let's look at the first. I'm going to get k. If I look at the second equation, I have 2k1 plus 5k2 plus 14k3 equal to 0. And I'm going to multiply the first equation by 2. I'm going to get 2k1 plus 4k2 plus 12k3 equal to 0. I'm going to subtract them. And what am I going to get? I'm going to get k2 here plus 2k3 equal to 0, which gives me k2 is equal to minus 2k3. So that's one relationship which I have between k2 and k3. I'm going to still concentrate on the first two equations, and I'm going to now try to get a relationship between k1 and k3 itself. So here I got rid of k1. In the next step, I'm going to get rid of k2 just by using the first two equations. I'm not touching the third equation yet. So if I look at the second equation, it is 2k1 plus 5k2 plus 14k3 is equal to 0. And then I'm going to multiply the first equation by 2.5. So I get 2.5k1 plus 5k2 plus 15k3 is equal to 0. And the reason why I multiply 2.5 is because I want to get rid of k2 so that I can develop a relationship between k1 and k3. So I subtract it. What do I get? Minus 0.45k1 plus minus k3 equal to 0. And from here I get k1 is equal to minus 2k3. So the two relationships which I have is k2 is minus 2k3 and k1 is minus 2k3. And keep in mind that I only use these first two equations to be able to develop these relationships. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to substitute it in the last equation and see what happens. So if I look at the last equation, I have 5k1 plus 7k2 plus 24k3 is equal to 0. So k1 is minus 2k3, and you got 7, k2 is minus 2k3 plus 24k3 equal to 0. And this gives me minus 10k3 plus minus 14k3 plus 24k3, and that gives me 0. And you can very well see I'm getting 0 equal to 0. So what that means is that the third equation is not giving me any more information, and it leads you to believe that I can choose any value of k3, and then the values of k1 and k2 are fixed. So I don't have to choose k3 equal to 0 because I didn't get k3 equal to 0 by substituting the values of k1 and k2 in terms of k3. So let's suppose if I choose k3 equal to 5. What that means is that from this equation, k1 will be equal to minus 2 times 5, which will be minus 10. And then from this equation right here, I'll get k2 equal to minus 2k3, which is 5 also, which is minus 10 also. So what that means is that k1 equal to minus 10, k2 equal to minus 10, and k3 equal to 5 is a solution. So we are clearly able to show another solution, not by observation, but by going through the equations to show that, hey, it is a solution. So we're getting a non-trivial solution because one of the scalars is non-zero. So what that basically means is that your A1 vector, A2 vector, this set of vectors which you have, these set of three vectors, are linearly dependent. They are not linearly independent, but they are linearly dependent. And that's how you go through the process to be able to figure out whether a particular set of vectors are linearly independent or not. And that's the end of this segment.